Okay, so last one will be shown here. Everything off this initial home base coming in. So I probably wouldn't do this with the fully came up because it's gonna be too much pressure. So I would do it with knees down. So maybe we're kind of like between situations. The knee's not super accessible, maybe he's flaring it out really far, like I mentioned last time, but he's also not electing to stand up. So it's not like a ton of pressure here. So I'm gonna limp arm out. So this, whether or not it had been at the hip because I was about to go, or if it's trapped here, it's gonna come to the same side hip. I'm gonna shoulder punch forward. I'm gonna close this face off with my chest. So from torso to torso. Now I'm getting an over under seat belt with the overhand being under, the underhand. And then I'm gonna knock him over. So my shin is gonna hit his knee as I'm leaning diagonally forward. I get hook number one, which pulls him up and allows me to get the bottom. So we'll just start here from this dog fight. Here, coming all the way out, limp arming, putting that shoulder down, and I'm not just like leaving it out here in space and disengaging, because he's gonna beat me down. I'm gonna have traded underhooks. So he's here. As soon as I do that, I'm closing off the space with my torso so he can't slice that elbow back. Underhand grabs me over, his leg on the outside. Into his knee as I roll it and move forward. Hook number one, pulling for hook number two. Limp arm goes off that space, roll, insert the hooks, and then if you guys want to practice belt chokes or create choke variations. Here, bringing it all the way around. Shut down for a couple minutes. One, two.